Travel Girls presents Growing Up Powerful, a guide to keeping confident when your body is changing, your mind is racing, and the world is complicated. Written by Nona Willis Aronowitz and narrated by Nona Willis Aronowitz with Alexandra Vaccaro, Aline Topchin, Beth Lucas, and Nicole Sparks.
Introduction. Hi there, Rebels. Welcome to Growing Up Powerful. We're so glad you're here. You might know Rebel Girls from our Goodnight Stories series or our podcast. Maybe you even have a favorite Rebel Girl, someone whose story you've read or listened to a bajillion times, someone you aspire to be like. We've loved sharing the inspiring tales of successful women around the world. And now we're starting a new, exciting chapter in our story. With this book, we're turning our focus to another super amazing, talented, curious rebel girl who has a big heart and even bigger dreams. Can you guess who it is? The answer is you. That's right. The book you hold in your hands is all about you and your best friend and your sister and your cousin and, well, you get the idea. Growing Up Powerful was created for this exact time in your life. The time when you're growing and learning and becoming your brilliant, kind, brave self. This time in your life will come with some challenges that may test your confidence. In fact, we know that between the ages of 8 and 14, girls report feeling a big drop in their confidence, and we're not okay with that. So we got together with a group of amazing rebel girls led by our author Nona Willis Aronowitz to help you navigate this important time while keeping your confidence as strong as ever. Think of this book as a how-to manual for this chapter, pun intended, in your life. We'll answer your questions and share our wisdom and advice. Together, we'll navigate all the ups and downs of puberty and middle school with curiosity and joy. What do you think of when you hear the phrase growing up? Maybe you think about starting a new school or making friends. Perhaps you think about your body changing or having more responsibilities at home. Maybe your mind goes to all the ways you can help out in your community as you become more independent. Perhaps there are excited butterflies fluttering in your stomach, or maybe it is more of an I'm about to lose my lunch sort of feeling. Luckily, whatever you're thinking of and however you're feeling, we've got you covered. Are you stressed about how much homework you suddenly have? Chapter 1 is all about how your mind works. It includes tons of tricks and tips for managing your workload and keeping your cool. Curious about getting your first period? Turn to page 98 and we'll walk you through everything you need to know. Want to get closer with your friends? Head to chapter 3 for a fun friendship Q&A activity. Not sure how to strike up a conversation with someone at your new school? Skip to chapter 4 for a run-through of exactly what to say to someone you'd like to be friends with. Trying to figure out how to jumpstart an idea you have for a community project? We'll get to that in chapter 5. Whatever you're going through and whatever questions you have, we've been there and we're here to help. In addition to all the great advice we've got for you, fun quizzes in every chapter will help you find the right type of exercise for you, discover what your next family activity should be, uncover your superpower, and more. Throughout this book, you'll also see stories and quotes from rebels you admire, as well as notes from girls around the world who are experiencing the very same things you are. Plus, at the end of every chapter, our team of experts answers thoughtful questions submitted by our amazing readers and listeners around the world. And for additional content, download the Rebel Girls app or go to rebelgirls.com/audio to listen to meditations, exercises, stories from girls just like you, and more. We know that growing up can be overwhelming at times, but it's also pretty amazing. As your body grows bigger and stronger and your mind expands, more and more incredible opportunities to show your talents and strengths will come your way. We feel so lucky to be here for you during this incredible time in your life, and to celebrate with you as you reach all the exciting milestones that come with growing up powerful. Stay Rebel, the Rebel Girls team.
Chapter 1. My brain is powerful. My brain is incredible. It's buzzing with thoughts, ideas, and big dreams. It allows me to do all sorts of things, from cartwheels to math, to memorizing all the lyrics to my favorite songs, to imagining stories in faraway lands. My brain is also in control of my feelings, from a spark of anger to those warm and fuzzies. It's still forming, which is cool, but it can also be super confusing. But knowledge is power, right? So learning about how my brain works can help me understand, decode, and navigate the world.
Your brain on the move. Right now, you're learning and growing so much, and that's in large part thanks to your brain. The changes your brain is going through will sometimes make you feel great, like when that tricky concept in algebra class finally makes sense and you feel that click of understanding. But other times, the changes going on inside your head might not feel fantastic, like when your sister stains your favorite sweater and all of a sudden you feel your emotions go into overdrive. Understanding why these things happen is super empowering. Let's get into it. That mushy gray lump in your head develops in spurts. And these years, the ones you're living right now, happen to be some big ones for your brain. Your brain is actually being rewired, adjusting to a new phase of your life. Two parts that are working incredibly hard right now, the amygdala and the prefrontal cortex. The amygdala is in the middle of the brain, and it's in charge of big, sometimes scary emotions: fear, worry, sadness, joy. It's also the part of the brain that sends signals about what to do in a stressful or dangerous situation. Scientists call this our fight or flight response, also known as a gut feeling. Your amygdala is maturing, but it's not quite done, which means it might be hard to regulate all those emotions right now. That sudden feeling like you want to burst into tears, the moment when your mood goes from happy and content to bummer city, believe it or not, that's your brain developing. So what is the prefrontal cortex up to? It's all the way in the front of our brains, and it helps us make decisions, plan our days, and think through situations carefully. It's the place that tells you to do your science homework, even though, all you want to do is keep chatting with your bestie. Brains don't put the finishing touches on the prefrontal cortex for many years, not until we're 25 years old. Before then, you might make mistakes and iffy choices that you wish you hadn't made. That's okay. Learning from those moments is part of growing up. Where does all the info go? There's a lot of information coming at our brains at any given time, from teachers and families and friends and phones and TVs. Woo! How do our brains possibly process it all? Well, first of all, research shows that adult brains and kid brains do this differently. Adults mostly process information through the prefrontal cortex, while preteens and teens process information more through the amygdala. And remember how the amygdala rules those great big emotions? That's why you might find yourself feeling, not thinking, when you decide to ride your bike without a helmet or scream at your sister for barging into your room. Some days, your brain might let you take a pause and think, how will this affect me in an hour, in a day, next year? Other days, it'll be really hard to stop yourself from reacting to the moment you're in. And whether you're a kid or an adult, different sides of your brain are responsible for different things. Our brains are divided by two hemispheres, the right side and the left side. The right controls our more creative, free-spirited side, while the left handles logic and words. There's a myth that some people are quote-unquote right-brained while others are quote-unquote left-brained. It's fun to think that our personalities come from one side or the other, but the truth is, everyone uses both sides of their brain. They're constantly working together, no matter what kind of person you are. We don't all learn the same. Our brains have the same basic parts, but they work in their own special ways. Some people learn best when they see things. The imaginations of eye learners are usually top-notch, and they might think in pictures rather than words. Others absorb knowledge best when they use their ears. Do you store up facts when you overhear conversations? Do you sound out words or raise your hand a lot in class? You might be a listener learner.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.